Part three, you made it. Welcome. This bit will be seeing a whole lot of frustrated David, I think, because it's the Dean stuff with Travis, who's wonderful to work with, and I really hope I get to do some comedy stuff with him in the future, because behind the scenes we had quite a good time with each other. It was a lot of fun, but I hope you enjoy this bit. This is going to be interesting for me because I had so many scenes where David was just like, "Ah, leave me alone," and really obviously leave me alone, and Dean just keeps turning up going, "I know you actually love me," which, you know, understandable, but let's see how this goes. It's going to be fun.
"You have no idea what you're talking about. Just leave us alone."
So that's the first pretty strong good, "just leave us alone" there. And Trav did a great job because I couldn't give him anything. Because in the writing, I could have been soft or whatever, so then he could then have something to go with. Like, oh, there must be still something there. But in reality, David's not going to give him anything because David would blame him partially for Aaron went on his own if David was there with him, rather than this whole thing Aaron might not be in hospital, but instead Dean caused this rift between David and Aaron, and then all this stuff's happened. So there's no way that David's going to be all that kind to him. And so Trav did a great job in maintaining that, no, I feel like there's something between us and I've got to keep pursuing that.
"The kind thing to do would be letting go. I was only trying to show you that. I am not interested in you. You're scared to take..."
Could I be any clearer?
"That's the fear talking.
Just bewilderment this of like, what? How can I be clearer? That's all I'm trying to do here. There's so much that David's already dealing with of Aaron being sick, in hospital, nearly dying, Freya putting the pressure on to not say anything, the fact that he's guilty over dealing with Gareth. That's all happening, and there's this cleaner at the hospital who's obsessed with him, who we can't just get rid of. What else am I supposed to do here, is pretty much what I'm giving here.
"You're trying to spin this like I am some kind of nut job, and you know that I'm not."
"Do I?"
"Oh, thank you very much. You obviously don't care about me at all."
"You're trying to break up my marriage. So no, I don't care about you. I just want you out of my life." Again, could I be any clearer? And it's actually quite nice from this point, some more stuff with Dean is to come. And yeah, it gets spicier. Let's say that, which is quite enjoyable. And it was actually kind of funny because there's a scene coming up where I should probably kind of go into that, so I won't. Thanks for watching the final third installment. I don't know if it's a final installment. We might have more. If you really like it, let us know. We'll try to do more as the storyline keeps progressing because it's still got quite a lot of legs in it. So keep enjoying it. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you got a few little insights into what goes on behind the scenes and what we do to make this all happen. So I'll see you next time. Bye.